Kozmos versus Archfiends. Hey everyone, my name is SeanArnold and welcome to another episode of Online Ranked for Yu-Gi-Oh! DevPro. Today I'm going to be messing around with my Archfiend deck a bit more, which I did a deck garage video a little bit early today. With the help of Bajorn, a good buddy of mine, he helped me update this deck a bit more and make some good improvements to it. And this is the fruits of my labor, as so to speak. So if you haven't seen that video, feel free to go and watch that one later on. If you want to kind of see the behind the scenes ideas which we came up with for this deck. Now I will warn you now that this video was done whilst I was streaming on Wednesday night, and I was having a few problems towards the end of the night with some cutouts, so there will be a few cutouts of the duel here, but for the most part most of it is still intact. So let's get down to some commentary. I've played Supply Squad on the field. Supply Squad is an awesome continuous spell card in Archfiends, which allows me to draw a card anytime my monster is destroyed, and Archfiends do a lot of destruction to themselves, so that kind of works here quite well, and we'll get to that later on. Then I play Tour Guide from the Underworld and Special Summon Fiendish Rhino Warrior, a new addition to this deck, a really really good milling card. But Fiendish Rhino Warrior, I'll talk more about what Fiendish Rhino Warrior can do when the time comes. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to rank 3 summon Wind Up Zen Mains. And Wind Up Zen Mains is going to attack my opponent directly. Wind Up Zen Mains is a good rank 3 monster. It's not as strong as it used to be, but because of the current changes to the format, but it is still pretty good. My opponent's going to play Emergency Teleport now, and then he's going to go and special summon a monster from his deck. It has to be a psychic level 3 or lower monster. So this would either tell me either A, he's playing Super Quantums, or it's Kozmos. Now I don't know too much about Kozmos, but I do know one thing, and that is you don't want to let Cosmo Farm Girl get her effect off. So what's going to happen now is you're going to see actually a bit of a cut quickly. Any second now, there you go, there's the cut. Sorry about that. We missed a turn there, but what I can tell you is I didn't attack Cosmo Farm Girl. I left her on the field. Then he tried to activate her effect and I responded with Solemn Warning, sent her to the graveyard, and then my opponent played his other spell or trap card, whatever that was. I think it was another copy of Emergency Teleport to special summon another copy, and some shenanigans happened. I did have to take some damage, but no, that's from Solemn Strike, sorry, not Solemn Warning. Alright, and I lost my Jar of Avery's by being destroyed. I think it might have been destroyed by MST or something like that, I can't quite remember. Anyway, it's my turn again. I normal summoned Archfiend Aeris. I've been calling that Trick Archfiend ever since playing DevPro. It's really hard and annoying to whenever I see the card named Trick Archfiend. But Archfiend Aeris on the field, and then I special summon Archfiend Commander. Now when you special summon Archfiend Commander, you have to destroy one Archfiend monster on your field. So destroyed Aeris, send that to the graveyard. That's going to let me then use Archfiend Aeris' effect to search out a card. Excuse me. A card from my deck to my hand. And then I get to draw one thanks to Supply Squad. Now, I'm not going to be able to do much this turn. I can't really normal summon again. I've already used my normal summon. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my battle phase. And I'm going to poke my opponent for a bit of damage there using Wind Up Zen Mains. I'm not going to be able to attack with Archery Commander because when he is special summoned in that method, he's not allowed to attack this turn. I really, really wish Archery Commander didn't have that limitation, and to a more bigger extent, I really wish Archfiend Cavalry did not have the limitation of stopping your monsters from attacking the turn they are special summoned through their effects. It's a little bit of a setback. It's I think it's an unnecessary downside to these cards. But it is what it is. Right, my opponent plays Cosmo Town. Cosmo Town is a really, really good field spell. Nothing I can do to stop that though. And he gets to add one of his banished Cosmo monsters from his banished pile to his hand. Just checking the stream is still alive there. He added one copy of Cosmo Farm Girl, and now he's summoned it. And let's see what he does here. I really don't want him to inflict battle damage to me, but he's not going to bother doing that. So he's going to banish her again, and then he's going to be able to special summon one bigger Cosmo monster. I think it's special summoned from his hand, and it is Cosmo Slip Rider. This card, when it is special summoned, you can target one spell or trap card on the field, destroy it. If this card is destroyed by battle or card effect and sent to the graveyard, you can banish this card from the graveyard, special summon one level 4 or lower Cosmo from your deck. Now, we went for to destroy my Archfiend Raw, so, which is fine by me. I decide to chain it. I special summon Archfiend Aeris from my graveyard. So there's no real downside of that now. I think he should have gone for my Supply Squad, to be honest, but that's okay. And let's see what he decides to do this turn. His monster is pretty big. He might try to do a bit of damage to me. He could attack Wind Up Zen Maze, perhaps. But let's see what he decides to do. I wonder if Kozmos run Cyber Dragon in this tech sometimes. Or whether people run Cyber Dragon as a tech against Kozmos sometimes. They're not all machines, but the bigger ones seem to be machine monsters. Right, so he plays Kozmos Slip Rider and then Limiter Removal. Now this is a really, really good play. Limiter Removal is a quick play spell card which doubles the attack of all machine cards on the field. And it's really, really good for OTK purposes and doing a lot of damage to your opponent quickly. Now, the reason why normally people would not play Limiter Removal unless they're going to win, at least that's what I'm used to. But the reason why Kozmos get away with doing so is because when that card is destroyed, he's going to get to Special Summon anyway. He's not going to lose any field presence. So a really, really cool idea to run Limited Removal in that deck. So there's his monster destroyed thanks to Limited Removal. He now gets to banish it and Special Summon 1 level 4 lower Kozmos from his deck. And unfortunately, I've lost my Archfiend Commander. And he Special Summons Kozmo Wicked Witch. This is a card during either player's turn, you can banish this card, special summon one level 5 or higher Kozmo from your hand during either player's turn, so it's going to dodge a lot of my effects. You can only use this effect of Kozmo Wicked Witch once per turn. Once per turn during either player's turn, you can play 1000 life points. This turn, this card cannot be destroyed by battle or card effects. Two fantastic effects for a level 4 monster, holy crap. Not only can it dodge my effects and special summon a bigger monster if it wants to, but it can protect itself from being destroyed by battle or card effects if it wants to as well. So I need to be really, really careful about what I pick from my deck to my hand. I really need to find something which can maybe get around that Wicked Witch, and if I can't get around it, then I need to find a way to kind of just give myself an advantage. Also, what you're seeing there in the stream chat there is people are asking me to download League of Legends. I've probably done it already, but I am going to start trying League of Legends out, but we'll see. So I added a copy of Archfiend Commander to my field hand, and now I've made another copy of Supply Squad, and I'm trying to think about how can I get around Wicked Witch, how can I stop her? I can't really target her, but it's really tricky to get around her. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try and create some shenanigans. I normal summon Cavalry, and then I'm special summon Archfiend Commander. Archfiend Commander is going to destroy Cavalry, and a lot of things are going to happen right now. When Cavalry is destroyed, both Supply Squads are going to activate and then they're going to trigger Cavalry's effect. Cavalry lets me special summon one Archfiend card from my graveyard when it is destroyed. So I'm going to special summon another copy of Archfiend Commander. However, and then I'm going to be able to draw two Supply Squad. So assuming all goes well, this should be pretty good. Okay. Now, when I was doing some deck building, Bajoran did say to me that a Supply Squad is really, really good in this deck. I did used to have a Supply Squad in my original build and then I took it out. But I've put it back in and I will say I am quite impressed with how Supply Squad has been working. It is pretty damn good. Alright, now I'm trying to think, what can I Synchro Summon or XE Summon to my field to kind of get over Wicked Witch but also kind of stop it in a way? And I don't really have any monsters in my extra deck that can do that. I don't want to target it at all. Targeting it seems to be pointless because it can just replace itself with another monster. So I think the best choice here might be to go for Bouncer. Again, I'm just trying to be as cautious as I can. Let's see what's going to happen here. I wish there were more options for a ranked build. Now, I made a mistake here. I decided to go and attack without realizing I actually can't attack with my commanders this turn. A little bit of a herp-a-derp moment there, but yeah, kind of sucks. So I'm going to go to main phase 2. I'm going to put, just going to play defensively, put same maze in defense, and I'm going to special summon another monster. Am I going to special summon another monster or am I just going to keep them on the field? It's hard to say. I could special summon another monster, maybe like Bouncer to put some kind of pressure on him in the next turn. And that's what I think I will do, but also keeping him on the field could also be good. Bouncer's not going to be able to stop that Kozmo Wicked Witch, but it will at least might be able to deal with something else. And it has a strong attack stat, so it's okay. Play Bottomless Trap Hole and Archfiend's Roar in case I need those two. And now it's back over to my opponent's turn here. Right, now my opponent plays Raigeki. gets rid of all the monsters on the field, but I should be able to protect my wind-up Zen mains using his own effects to avoid destruction, which I will do there. And now I'm going to dump Fiendish Rhino to the graveyard. Now a couple of things are going to happen here. Supply squads are going to activate, and also Fiendish Rhino Warrior is. Fiendish Rhino Warrior has a special effect, and that is when it is sent to the graveyard, it can send another fiend type monster from my deck to the graveyard. Really, really solid card for loading my graveyard with Archfiends, as I like to do. So I sent Trick Archfiend to the graveyard, or Archfiend Aeris, and Archfiend Aeris is now going to allow me to add one more card to my hand after I've drawn two for the supply squads. Now the question is which card to go for. I could go for Commander again, I could go for Cavalry. I'm thinking about maybe going for Genesis Archfiend or Archfiend Emperor, but there isn't really anything I could destroy this turn. It's hard to say, it's really hard to say. So I'm going to play it safe and go for Commander, and we'll see what I can do in the next turn also. Alright, now it's over to my opponent again. He's going to play Cosmo Town, add one Cosmo monster that has been banished. He's going to get Slip Rider and add it back to his hand. And now he's going to be able to special summon it again quite easily this turn. And he's probably going to destroy one of my spell attract cards on the field. Let's see though if he does that or he chooses not to. Yep, banishes Wicked Witch. I'm not going to be able to chain to it. Is he going to summon Slip Rider? No, he summons something else. He summons Dark Destroyer. When this card is special summoned or normal summoned, you can target one monster on the field, destroy it. Cannot be targeted by your opponent's card effects. If this card is destroyed by a battle or card effect and sent to you the graveyard, you can banish this card, special summon one level 7 or lower Cosmo from your deck. So he's going to try and destroy my Zen Maze, but I don't think that's the real reason why he wanted it there. I think he wants that monster to be destroyed. But fortunately, I have Bottomless Trap Hole, which is not going to send his monster to the graveyard when it is destroyed. It will banish it, which is going to be pretty good. Even though Cosmos like the banish power can come back quite easily because they're all about going through space and different dimensions and stuff, the, being able to banish that card is going to stop it from special summoning anything big again this turn. Alright, end phase, Zen Maze is now going to be able to pop a card thanks to its own effect. And I could chain Archfiend Raw that right now, but there's no point really. Cosmo Town, when it is destroyed, it can add one Cosmo monster or what Cosmo card from my opponent's deck to their hand. Really good recycling effect there, keeps his card economy the same. So, not really a loss there. He adds another copy of Cosmo Town so he can add more monsters to his hand. Right, my turn there, and there was another cut there, I'm afraid. Sorry, I did lose the stream there a bit. What I did do is I played Mathematician, and I sent another Fiendish Rider to the graveyard, then Fiendish and Archfiend Emperor. Then I special normal summon Cavalry, and now I'm going to attack with all my monsters to try to do a lot of damage to him, leaving him 500 life points. And now I'm going to special summon Commander, and Commander is now going to destroy Cavalry and activate all three copies of Supply Squad that I have. First, I'm going to special summon a monster, and it's going to be another copy of Archfiend Commander, and now I'm going to draw three cards. Then I'm going to special summon, I really wanted to special summon another copy of Bouncer this turn, but unfortunately Bouncer is already destroyed, and that would be great because I could have put some pressure on my opponent to negate his effects and burn the rest of his life points away. So first I'm going to special summon Down the Magician to make use of that Zen mains that's on the field and has no more materials, and now I'm trying to decide whether it's even worth special summoning anything because it's not like those monsters can activate in my opponent's turn. First, I'm going to play Foolish Burial, get rid of another card from my deck. Send down another copy of Fiendish Rhino. Fiendish Rhino can't activate again, it can only activate once per turn. I don't think I have any more Fiend type monsters in my deck. And now I'm going to end my turn and pass over to my opponent and let's see what he's going to do. I'm in a really good position here with him only on 500 life points. He's not going to be able to pay for some of his Cosmo effects, and he's going to be quite vulnerable. I don't think he has much in terms of back row, but he's still one of the best decks in the game right now, so he might be able to come back. Let's see what my opponent can do. and he surrenders. So, good game to you, dude, and hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, a little episode of Archfiends versus Kozmos. I know I enjoyed playing that game, so hopefully you guys enjoyed watching it. Sorry for the cuts there through the stream, still working out what's going on there, I'm not sure why those were cutting out, just seems to be a thing that happens. But regardless, I hope you guys enjoyed the video anyway. Anyway, I'll see you guys soon, and take care of yourselves.